Moving your self-hosted WordPress site to a new domain requires attention and two distinct stages. Hello there, my name is Robert from tmile.com and in this video I'll show you every step to move a WordPress site to another domain. And one more thing that will help you not lose the traffic that Google sends to your site. But I'll tell you more about it in the next minutes, so please continue watching. See, the actual process to move WordPress to a new domain is fairly simple. You basically just need to copy your files to a new folder on your host and update your database. But keeping your SEO rankings when you do it takes some care. To that end, I'm going to show you both stages of the process. Let's dive into the first stage. At a high level, you just need to use the duplicator WordPress plugin to move your site's files to your new domain. The process is pretty much identical no matter whether you are sticking with the same host or moving to a new WordPress host. Here's how to do it. As always, make sure you back up your site before beginning this process. Then, get started by installing and activating Duplicator. Once it's activated, head to the Duplicator link in your dashboard sidebar and create a new package. Move through the package creation process and build your package. You don't need to change any of the default settings. Duplicator will build your package, which consists of two files, installer and archive. You need to download both files. Remember where you save them because you'll need them soon. Next, you need to create MySQL database for your new domain. Head to cPanel and find the MySQL databases option. Then create a new database, and then a new database user. You need to add that database user to the database you just created, and make sure to give it all privileges. And that's it! Keep the database name, username and password handy, because you'll also need them in a second. Now you need to upload the downloaded files to the root folder for your new domain name. The quickest way to do this is using File Manager. To open File Manager, find its icon on cPanel and make sure to choose your new domain name for the document root option. Then you can use the upload button to upload each file. Now you can head to newdomain.com/installer.php to run the duplicator install process, where newdomain.com is obviously your actual domain name. Enter the details for the database you created. And then, on the next screen, you hit a very important step, specifying your new domain name. Duplicator should automatically detect your new domain, but if not, make sure you enter your exact URL in the box. Then, Duplicator will handle updating all your internal URLs and image links to reflect your new domain. Once that's done, all you need to do is hit the Save Permalinks button to update your links. And then test your site to make sure everything is working properly. And that's all you need to do to move WordPress to a new domain name. If you didn't care about your SEO rankings, you could call it a day right now. But I told you this tutorial is about covering both parts. So, let's get into the how to keep your SEO rankings. You need to do two things here. Number one is to set up 301 redirects to send all links and traffic from your old domain to your new domain. And the second one is to tell Google that you changed your domain name. 301 redirects basically tell web browsers and search engines that your site has permanently moved. For example, with proper 301 redirects, anyone who goes to your old domain will automatically get redirected to your new domain. This helps preserve your traffic and keeps the SEO value of links pointing to your old website. To add 301 redirects, all you need to do is edit the htaccess file for your old site and include the following code. You can copy this code by accessing the link to our article in the description box below this video. Just make sure to replace newdomain.com with the actual link to your new domain name. Your htaccess file is in the root directory of your site. That is the same directory that includes wp-admin and wp-content. You can either access it using an FTP program or edit it in your browser using File Manager, like I showed you before. Once you add the code to your htaccess file, make sure that it's working properly by visiting a page on your old domain. You should be automatically sent to the equivalent page on your new domain name. When you move WordPress to a new domain name, it's also a good idea to give Google a heads up. Nowadays, Google actually gives you a form that you can fill out letting them know you changed your domain name. To access it, head to Google Search Console and open the property for your old domain name. If you never registered your site with Google Search Console, you'll need to do that first. Then, click on the settings gear icon and choose change of address. Then, fill out the form and click submit. In addition to the two core steps mentioned in this video, it's also a good idea to perform some other basic housekeeping tasks, and I invite you to read more about those steps in our article, which you can access by clicking the link in description below this video. Thanks for watching. Click the parrot on the screen right now to subscribe, then click the bell and check send all notifications for this channel. This way, you'll be notified every time we upload our latest tutorials about WordPress. Share them if you like what you see. Hit the like button and ask any question in comments below.